It's Omracer here, and today we're going to be reviewing the Immortal Camcorder sunglasses. So, let's be honest here, my second pair of Google Glass has died, which, again, after this, I'm not going to go never into it, especially as it's only good for the purpose of just recording videos now. The smart side of things has been gone. So, I need a replacement. Looking online, essentially, there was some, obviously, knockoff cheap sunglasses around which do the recording, which is great. But you look at them, it's like, actually, the format's going to be this, and it's like, no. So, I found these on eBay. Costing $39.70. However, due to it actually costs me double that. We're not off to a good start on that side of things. But will it perform for the double money I've actually paid for it? And here is the packaging. A simple black box with the Immortal logo on. Well, actually, this is the front. To say Camcorder sunglasses. Each side says Immortal. And then on this side, it says 720p HD. One button control. Up to 32 gig of memory, and they give you a micro SD card included, plus the Immortal websites, which actually are defunct and do not work as of this video. So be aware of that if you are looking into these. The barcode and the CE approved, WEC bin logo, FC approved as well. So a simple box, really. A simple box in cellophane. Apparently, this person was selling multiple versions. So we're now going to unbox them. Let's use a cheap method of a staple. And here we go. So now we're going to see what is in the box. So first we have the user guide. So yeah, I give that reason because that gives you a nice look of what the manual looks like. Then you've got the USB cable, which is a mini USB cable, which is fine, which is better connection for most cases. Then you've got the charger, 5 volts, 1 amp. You get a car charger, gives you 5 volts per half an amp, 500 milliamps there. And then you get some extra clips for the frame, if I remember correctly. You get your 8 gig class 4 micro SD card. Now, class 4 is terrible. End of. I mean, there's even, people think class 10 is amazing, but even that's not good. You've got to have class 10 V3 for the best results for any videos. Sadly, they don't. That's how it goes. Class 4 is very budget and cheap. But then again, this was 4 to 8 years ago. They do make things a little bit different in that regard. And then the nice thing as well, you've got a case. Nice proofing case, which is quite cool, which you can attach things to it. We open that up. To then finally look at the glasses. So you get some spare lenses in its cellophane-y form. And then we have the glasses themselves in the cellophane wrapping. So that is what they look like. Quite bulky, quite big. You fold out, there's your model number and the button there. There was another button, which is not really a button at all on this side. You've got the charging port, which is a mini B. And then you've got the SD card slot as well. And the button, which does work, which is a nice little feature. And then you've got the shades where you can actually push them out and push them in. Then you've got the nice camera as well, which actually is quite bulky as well, which is a good thing. So the quality's there. But no, it looks like a nice solid piece of kit there. Now, let's see how to try with the sunglasses on. Now, don't I look actually cool? You can see the UV filter when you're using these as well. So before we start using them, we've got to see how the clips and the lenses come off, which apparently not to touch this bit from what I read in the instructions, or there's a YouTube video which I'll link in the blog post on how to snap these off, which they just slide out like that, really. And then you can see them without any lenses. Now, I probably will be using this method a bit more because it is easier for me. And then I can then slide them in. Like that. And there we are. That's how they work. So that makes it easy and easier to snap in. Let's see how they go and fit on me. It So yeah, actually, it feels like I'm back in DT with these. Well, it covers as a mask as well, partly. They look alright. They look pretty cool. And they don't feel really uncomfortable. Unlike other ones, they can be really uncomfortable and plasticky. The bulky does feel nicer as well. And so that's how it looks on that one. So it's time to see how things really do go. So we aren't going to use the SD card it comes with, because I know that performance is shocking. So good old SanDisk with the Ultra 32 GB ones. We're going to fit that in to its magic. Now, if I remember correctly, it does say very, very faintly on that icon to go in like so. That way. One good thing I do not like about rubber flaps, they are hard to do. Sometimes you need the actual edge of the SD card to help you get it in, and then it's in. Perfect. And now it is time to give them a charge. Now, since it is a SIM 5 volt, 1 amp charger, we're going to probably use a better charger to say the word. So we're going to charge that up, and then we're going to start some testing. So this is the recording to see if it's going to work. After those quick test recordings, probably is the battery at the moment, so it's just charging up. We're going to do some nice little day in the life testing tomorrow, because it is like 11 o'clock at night at the moment. It seems interesting so far. Quality is better than I was expecting it. Sound is all right. Not tinny compared to glass, but not crystal clear compared to talking on the vlog right now with a Redmi Note 7. Okay, here we go. So I'm recording and tying a dog walk at the same time. Now, these filters actually do look like they've really blinded the screen completely, but I think it is time we go for a walkies, because it's a fresh day. So, why not? It's a lovely Sunday morning, actually. A really fresh one. Hands are cold. Rosie's been walked. The ground, you can see, is frosty. Very frosty. But it's this cold air, but it's fresh cold air, which is also nice, because it just dries everything up eventually. I'm just hoping it's going to be like this tomorrow as well, because we've got work. Back to my originals. That's not right. So let's see if this is now going to pick up as a camera in my videoing, which is the most crucial moment. Awesome, it comes up. Amazing. The date, though, is a bit off, but it does import both of them as it should be. So it says it's imported it. See how it plays.
So this is the recording to see if it's going to work.
So there we are. So after a long day of work and trying little bits and pieces, there are some good and there are some bad points of it. Let's not be biased at one point or another. Yes, there's a few quality issues. Not build. The build's nice, I will admit. Not like, it's flimsy. No, it's quite solid. So that's good. And Yeah, the quality of the videos feels like the action camera I reviewed a fair bit ago. It feels like that. Not fisheye, but like that not very... The saturation is drained, gone out, really. But it records. It's easy to import. It's not a struggle to import footage. So I can't complain there. I'm going to give this one a 5 out of 10. Good value if I didn't get double purchased. Decent build quality. Easy to import the footage, and it is a good codec for recording. No stabilization, no whatsoever. Mic can be a bit muffled, and there's not an easy way to actually know when it's recording, and the saturation is quite dry on there. But yeah, that's about it. We'll catch up soon for some more reviews, which I've got a few bits behind the scenes I've been trying to do during everything going on, which I'll do a vlog on that all the time, and then hopefully next week or two. But I'll see you from then. OmRacer is out.